had some beauties in New York.
Here they go.
I heard his name a little bit.
You know, I tried to fight Probert for a couple of years.
Domi is determined.
They told me that Probert and Domi was the best thing that ever happened to New York one year.
First time I actually ran into Ty Domi was on the ice.
What a wild one this is.
They had two beauties down, round one and round two.
Before I know it, we're on the ice, and Ty skated up to me and said, come on, Probert, let's go, let's go.
And he never really gave me a shot at it. He's like, get away from me, kid. Get away from me.
You know, the next shift, same thing. Come on, Probert, let's go. So finally, I just dropped my nose and we fought.
Probert and Domi going at it off the faceoff.
Interesting matchup, you would say.
Domi finding it difficult to reach the taller Probert.
But Probert just got one in. Now he's got the helmet to contend with.
Determined.
He's got Probert, Sam. He got Probert over the right eye with a couple of lefts.
Oh, now big Probert's coming back. And he's gotten Domi a couple of shots. What a wild one this is.
What's that signal, Sam? You pick that one up? Heavyweight belt, is that it?
Domi and Probert go off.
You know, he kind of got a lucky one in, grazed me a little bit, cut me above the eye, and it didn't hurt or anything like that, but it didn't look good.
He hit me a few times, but, you know, I got him a few times, too, and I ended up getting lucky, and sometimes in a fight you get cut. You know, it doesn't matter if you win or lose, sometimes somebody gets cut, you know, if you hit the guy in the right spot or whatever. And I ended up cutting him and making a big deal about it and doing the WWF thing. And
I was a little pissed off at that. I was uncalled for. And I looked at him as being a young, cocky kid. But I guess we're all cocky at that age.
When you make fun of the other guy after a fight and that, you don't have any respect.
I personally can't stand the showboating or the entertaining aspect of players after a fight, if they win the fight and they go to the penalty box with their hand up in the air, they're number one, or smiling, or you know, whatever. I just think it's a sign of a young, cocky hockey player, and players like that, unless they change, which they usually do, they usually don't last long in the league.
One of the turning points of my career came the day Mark Messier was traded to the New York Rangers.
He's like E.F. Hutton. When he speaks, players listen, and the Rangers need that.
We were playing against Buffalo, and I ended up fighting somebody and doing pretty good. And ended up scoring a goal and riding my stick in 6-2. And after a fight too, I kind of got a little cocky.
Think Domi's having a night.
I ended up going in the dressing room, thinking, oh, all right, you know, third star, and Mess goes, Ty, come here.
Ty obviously was like not unlike any other young player that comes in the league, who's has to play with an edge and has to be confident in themselves, especially for the job that he was doing.
Took me in the trainer's room, and he sat me down. And he looks at me and he says, "Listen, enough's enough. No more of that shit you're doing after your fights and after your goals." He says, "You're never going to get respect in this league. If you don't respect your peers, you're never going to get respect in this league."
Ty had a lot to learn in a lot of areas of the game, and I think perhaps that particular incident was one where he needed to be shown how to act in a particular fashion in a particular time of the game.
So then after I'm changed, I'm showered, and, you know, I'm kind of intimidated by him, right? So I'm not saying a word to him. And then we're getting dressed, and he comes over to me and goes, "Where are we going?" I was like, "Where are we going?" I don't know, wherever. You know, and we ended up going out that night and, you know, having a couple and having a great time. And, you know, he never changed his attitude towards me, but that's the type of guy he was. He's like, "Hey." And he grabbed me and he pulled me back, and, you know, I stopped doing that stuff, and I ended up getting more respect in the league.